Hello there guys and gals, the Welsh Hunter here, back with yet another 100% achievement guide, and this time we are getting it all in the fun little puzzler, Bouncyboi in Puzzleland. Now this was developed and published by Twin Stick, and is available for $11.74/$13.99 US dollar bill. So we play as Bouncyboi, who has this epic story of not actually having a story, while simultaneously not having any goals to follow. It is an incredibly thought out story-wise. Now, we are just a big, bald, purple slime egg who has to get through obstacles to get to the other side. Kind of like a white the chicken cross the road type thing, except it's nothing like that at all. Now, achievements are nice and easy too. There are 5 worlds, 10 levels each, so we get an achievement for completing each world. We have to get 25 gold medals at least from every level, but it is very simple and I show you gold on every single level anyway. There is also one collectible in each world that we have to get, so I'll let you know where they are when we get there. There's also a missable achievement in the last world, the wormy world, and the one that the devs thought would be good to troll us with. Bounce 5,000 times. Yeah, dings, he says sarcastically. Either way, you'll get this game done in around 1.5 to 2 hours, mainly thanks to the final 5,000 bounces we have to do. So with that being said then, let us begin. And we're going to begin immediately with the first one, and all we have to do is press the left stick to go, obviously, left, right, up or down. And now and again, we'll have to press the A button. Now, a lot of this game comes in the terms of if you jump on a different path, it'll move a part of the world. So jump on this one, and as you can see, we move the gate. So you have to move back one to go back to go forward. So going forward is not always the best option. So going backwards sometimes helps you go forward in that type of thing. And again, I should point out, I won't be speaking a lot through this game due to me not really being needed. Let's face it. I mean, you get pissed off at me saying, go up, down, all around, tickle your nuts 1,000. There's just no point this time. But I will be there now and again when a new collectible or achievement is appertaining. But as you can see, with these flowers, sometimes you'll have flowers and other things that you can press the A button near to change the bridge and change other parts of the environment as well. It's a very simplistic, thought-out game, but it works on so many levels, and it is actually quite a fun one. So, just start getting used to it. I've tried to go at a decent enough pace for you to follow, so hopefully you can follow along with the video nice and easy. And like I said, I'll be back with any collectibles and achievements. Also, another thing I should mention is a lot of the time you'll get these messages which will basically say you have to appease something or you have to do something or other, but literally it makes no difference. This is, you don't get timed or anything, so you can literally just follow along at your own pace. No one will try to hurt you. It's literally a case of if you go in one direction, the enemy will go in another direction. So again, you don't have to panic. The messages basically mean nothing to us, which is always handy. So now then, this is where we're going to get our first collectible. Like I said, there's a collectible in one in each world, and they are usually very well hidden, and you'll always hear like this hidden chime every time you step on one of the hidden collectible sort of platforms. So from here, we'll just go to the right. We'll go up and we're actually going to stop on the lily pad. So by the time you get up, the frog will be up there. Press the A button on here. And this is where the first out of five collectibles are. Beautiful Froggo's hoodie. Wow, fit. And then what we can do to get the gold medal, we can just press and hold the Y button now to restart the level. You'll still have the collectible collected, and it won't be affected, and restarting the level won't affect the gold medals either. So press and hold the Y button until like a frog's fart sounds like it's happening, and then we can start again and go from here. Yes! Thank you.
Bish bash bosh, real good nosh, we just beat Mozzie's Swamp, mate. Well done.
So, that's the first one done. You should now get the achievement called Mozzie's Swamps, completing Mozzie's Swamps. Then we can just go into Crystal's Cave and, well, let's begin again. Now, even though some will say beware the crumbling tiles or anything, they don't actually fall from underneath you, I don't think anyway, so you can just go on one, go on to another one, and then it falls. So, don't panic with all these messages on screen, especially with a spider who shoots webs at you. He's not going to randomly target you, so just keep following along exactly how I've done it, and you'll have near but a problem.
Thank you.
So, level 9, level 2 out of level 2.9 even, is where we're going to get the second collectible, the old winged Batman. We're going to turn into purple bald Batman right now, which is cool. So from here, we're just going to go right once, and then up once, and you hear the hidden chime, press the A button on here, and then we turn into Batman. Where is she? Etc, etc. So that's that one done. So again, press and hold the Y button to restart it, and follow along.
Lovely. Now you can build Batman stuff.
Thank you.
So, time to grab yet another collectible. This will be the third one. So what we need to do is basically get to the very right-hand side bottom corner of the map. So go down and then back up, so the bridge turns around. Go across and then up. And then press the A button here. And then jump back down, jump down, jump up, and jump back down. Then jump back up and jump back down, jump up, jump down. And there we go. Now we can go across and jump down here into the bottom middle one. Press the A button. And that is where the collectible is. So now we're kind of like, it's supposed to be Spook Sister's hat, but we kind of look like a, we go into a, you know, terrible Halloween party in a terrible Halloween costume to get off our nut. But of course, how things change. These days, I'm walking around asking for sweets off everyone to give to the kids. Yeah, right, the kids. Yeah. Life changes when you're an adult. You gotta steal what you can. Especially in these hard times in the British economy, where the Tory government likes to bend you over, electric and gas-wise. British people don't know what I mean. So, as we get to this big bad mask, Majora's Mask as it were, we're going to get the first of the collectible in this world basically immediately. So, immediately as we begin, we're going to go left twice, press the A button here, and that is the collectible already done. So now we've got actually the coolest collectible in the game. Monty Burns' Mask. Excellent.
Thank you.
now then, we are coming up to the final world. We're also going to be coming up to the only sort of missable achievement in the game as well, apart from the collectibles and the gold medals, of course. So, every three moves that you make, Wormy will come and stick his big fat head right next to yours. So, for this achievement, we have to get trapped in a corner three times by little Wormbag. So, it's easy to do it on this first level. So, yep, yeah, whatever. What we're going to do is go right, left, and then right. Wormy's going to appear here. And then we're going to go left, right, and left. Wormy's going to go there and basically trap us. The game is going to tell us that we can't move anywhere. And all we have to do then, we have to do that three times, a total of three times. And then when you begin again, the achievement will unlock. So do this two more times. Job done. Up the bum. There we go. 1,000. I'm full of sense today. Apparently not. Are we ready for the final collectible? Why, of course we are. So this is what we're going to do. This is where we're at the well level. Or you could call it that because there's a well in the middle of the level. Right, so we have to go behind the well. What we have to do then is go up and then right and then down. Important. And then we can go up, up and right. And now press the A button here. This is what gets us the last achievement. Probably the worst looking collectible in the game. Just looks like we, we're about to, change, I don't know if I should say that one. No, I'll probably leave that one. But anyway, we've got a bow. We're basically going to now take part in loads of women's sports and break the records for them. Whoops, I said it. Anyway, that's the final collectible. You'll get the Happy Easter achievement, and now we are free to go until the very end. Hoo-hoo! And that is all five worlds done, but we do have two more achievements left to get. One is just for finishing this little sort of outro, if you will, this little epilogue. if you want to call it that. All we have to do is basically go all the way to the right until the Finn achievement unlocks. And then we get to finally do the achievement where we pretty much get trolled. Where the devs thought, you know what's a good idea? Nathan Shepherd, thank you for the final achievement. He says sarcastically, thanks. But yes, I think Nathan must have thought, well, we can't have everyone just doing this too easy. We need them to grind like hell first, of course. So we now have to bounce, and obviously what we have to do is just go left and right basically 5,000 times. That's yeah. So you can go on any level you want. I just literally went on the very first level. But this is going to take you anywhere between, if you do it basically constantly without taking breaks, you can get this done between in around 35 to 40 minutes. Yes, it does take that long, so I would get up something on your phone. If you're watching a TV series on Netflix, I would definitely, and as you can see, I only got 20% of the way there. So even after all that, plus the restarts and everything, I only got 20% of the way there. So yes, this does take around another 30 to 40 minutes. It took me around 52 minutes-ish. But that's because I was falling asleep and I had to pause and go and get a coffee. Otherwise, I was going to smash my head on my desk whilst falling asleep. But this is what you... So yeah, make sure you've got a pretty good bit of entertainment ready. So you can bounce your way 5,000 times. But as soon as you have done 5,000 times... We should now be able to... Oh man, this was a slog. This was an absolute grind fest. But there's been worse, funnily enough. Sadly, we don't even get a rare achievement for it anymore, which is a pain in the ass. But there we go, that's 5,000 bounces done. And that is Bouncyboi in Puzzleland all done. We are going to go and break some more women's records now in various sports. But that should be your 10 out of 10. Sorry. I'm just joking, of course. But there we go then, guys and girls. So hopefully you enjoyed the game, hopefully you enjoyed the guide as well. I hope the guide was well paced enough so that you could follow along nice and easy. Please let me know if it was or wasn't, or if you think I should just talk more anyway in every guide of mine. If it did help, of course, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe and share with a friend. Don't forget to check me out on my socials, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook and Patreon. And again, huge shout out to everyone on Patreon who continues to support the channel. You guys and gals are just legends. And there we go then, guys and gals. So thank you so much. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye-bye, big love.